RBI's Operation Twist Monetary Policy. Recently, RBI decided to undertake Special Open Market Operations (OMO), which is sometimes referred to as Operation Twist. Such an operation was carried out by the RBI to reduce the long-term interest rates and improve the monetary policy transmission. The move by the RBI is considered to be significant mainly for the two reasons. Firstly, it is considered to be conventional monetary policy tool to influence the interest rates. Secondly, it was the first time that the RBI carried out such operation. Hence, in this regard, let us understand as to what Operation Twist is all about and how it influences the long-term interest rates. Understanding the basics, the government issues government bonds known as government securities or G-Secs in order to borrow money. These G-Secs have mainly three characteristics: face value, fixed interest rate, that is coupon rate, and maturity period. These G-Secs are also traded in the secondary market, wherein they are bought and sold by various investors. In the secondary market, two related aspects of G-Secs, including the other bonds, also come into picture, that is bond price and bond yield. The bond price is current market price of the bond in the secondary market. The bond price depends upon the demand for the bond. Higher the demand, higher would be the bond price, and lower the demand, the lower would be the bond price. The yield on the bond refers to the annual returns on the bond. The yield depends on the purchase price of the bond and the coupon rate. It is calculated as interest on the bond by market price on the bond into 100. Let us understand that these concepts by taking an example. Let's say the government issues a government security with a face value of rupees 100. The maturity period is 10 years and it carries the coupon rate of 10%. Such a G-Sec has been bought by an investor A. So the investor A would get rupees 10 as an interest on annual basis. Now the bond price is same as the face value, that is rupees 100. The yield would be 10 by 100 into 100, that is rupees 10. Going forward, let's say the investor sells the G-Sec to another investor B in the secondary market at rupees 90. So the bond price now is rupees 90. Accordingly, the yield would become 10 by 90 into 100, that is 11.11%. On the other hand, if the investor A sells the G-Sec to another investor B at 110 rupees, then the bond price would be 110 and the yield would be 10 by 110 into 100, that is 9.09%. So it is clearly visible that when the bond price increases, the yield is coming down. Now looking at both the examples, it can be inferred that the bond prices and the bond yields are inversely proportional to each other. As the bond price increases, the bond yields would reduce, and the bond prices decrease, the bond yields would increase. This can be summed up as follows. Higher the demand for the bonds in the market, increase in the bond prices leads to decrease in the bond yields. Lower the demand for the bonds in the market, decrease in the bond prices, increase the bond yields. What is the yield curve? The yield curve is a graph that depicts the yield on bonds ranging from short-term debt such as 1 month to longer-term debt such as 30 years. Usually, in order to track the yield curve, the yields of the government bonds are taken into consideration. The yields on the bonds depends upon the risk involved. Higher the risk, higher would be the yields. Normally, the yield curves on short-term maturity bonds is lower than that of long-term maturity bonds. Higher yields on the long-term maturity bonds can be attributed to increased risk in the long term, say 30 years. Hence, under the normal conditions, the yield curve is upwards sloping like this. The yield curve is upward sloping, you can see here. As the maturity is going on, the yield is increasing. So the yield is going to increase whenever the maturity, that is long term. For long term, the maturity increases and the yield also increases. So this is the upward sloping yield curve, normal yield curve. What are the open market operations? So these are the open market operations. What are they involved? RBI and banks are involved. During the economic slowdown, there is no cash in the economy, so banks need money to lend. RBI wants the banks to lend money to the people to increase the liquidity in the country during the economic slowdown. So RBI gives money to the banks to give it to the people, and RBI purchases the government securities. During the inflation, that is during the high liquidity in the market, RBI takes away money from the banks and sells the G-Secs to the banks. So this is called open market operations. OMOs, the open market operations refers to the buying and selling of the government securities by the RBI in order to control the liquidity in the economy. When RBI feels that there is a liquidity, excess liquidity in the market, it resorts to sale of the securities, thereby sucking up the rupee liquidity. Similarly, when the liquidity conditions are tight, the RBI may buy securities from the market and thereby releasing the liquidity into market. Understanding the operation twist. So what is the difference between the operation twist and the open market operations? So if it is the same, then why operation twist? We'll call open market operations itself, but there is some changes. So that is the reason we call operation twist. So RBI sells the short-term G-Secs. Here, instead of giving money to the banks, short-term G-Secs it sells to the banks and purchases the long-term G-Secs. So this is operation twist. It purchases the long-term G-Secs, indirectly creating the demand. See what happens when it, the RBI purchases the long-term G-Secs. What happens? There is no long-term G-Secs with the bonds, right? The yield on the long-term G-Secs bonds decreases. So banks offer more interest rates to the people. So Operation Twist is the name given to the monetary policy tool that the US Federal Reserve have initiated to influence the prevailing rate of interest in the markets. The tool essentially aims at changing the shape of the yield curve, hence the name Twist. So simultaneously buying and selling of long-term government bonds. Operation Twist is a special open market operation carried out by the RBI. It is called special open market operation because RBI would be simultaneously buying and selling the government securities. The RBI would sell the short-term G-securities to the banks and financial institutions and collect money. And the same money would then be used by the RBI to buy long-term government securities. The RBI has decided to sell the four short-term securities maturity of period of 1 year. The government has decided to sell four short-term securities maturity period of 1 year worth 10,000 crore and simultaneously buy the long-term securities for maturity period of 10 years. Impact of the operation twist. When RBI buys the long-term government securities, there would be a decrease in the supply and increase in the demand for the long-term G securities in the market. As discussed before, the higher demand would lead to the increase in the bond prices and decrease in their yields. On the other hand, RBI sells the short-term government securities, thereby would be increased supply and lower the demand for the short-term government securities in the market. This decreased demand would then lead to decrease in the bond prices and increase in their yields. Hence, the operation twist would bring down the rates of interest on long-term loans and increases the rate of interest on the short-term loans. So this is the main purpose of the operation twist, that is to bring down the rates of the interest of the long-term loans and also the increase the rate of interest on the short-term loans. Why the operation twist has been done? See, you can see here the Reserve Bank of India, from the source it is taken. See, the percentage of policy rate and the yields on the government securities, it is constantly decreasing since 2014 to 2018. If you see here the policy repo rate, see, whenever the repo rate is decreased, the yield maturity on the treasury bills is also being decreased, and also the yield on 10-year maturity, that is long-term yields, should also decrease, but it is not happening. That is, the interest rates on the long-term securities are not decreasing with the decrease of the repo rate. See, you can see the red line is, whenever there is decreasing, there is a huge gap between the decrease of the interest rates. So we can clearly see the yields are going to increase, right? So to change this graph, RBI has introduced the operation twist. Despite reducing the benchmark repo rate by almost 135 basic points, the banks have reduced the interest rates by only 45 basic points. Hence, poor monetary policy transmission has not led to commensurate the reduction in the rates of interest of long-term loans, which is necessary to kickstart the slowing economy. Further, yields on the 10-year government securities is also considered as a benchmark by the banks. The banks keep the yield rates on 10-year government securities as a reference in giving the loans to the long-term government borrowers. See, it is clearly mentioned that the yields on the 10-year government securities is also considered as a benchmark by the banks. See, this yield is considered as a benchmark. Because of these yields only, the government decides the interest rates. So, bank keeps the yield rates on 10-year government securities as a reference in giving loans to the long-term borrowers such as home buyers, vehicle buyers, infrastructure companies, and the higher yields on the 10-year G-Secs had in turn led to the increase in the long-term interest rates in the Indian economy. So decreasing the yield rates of the 10-year government securities is indirectly decreasing the long-term interest rates of Indian economy. Hence, Operation Twist has sought to reduce the yields on 10-year government securities so as to reduce the interest rates on the government long-term loans. As shown in the figure, the yields on the 10-year government securities has reduced from 6.74% to 6.54%, nearly a 0.20% decrease. You can see here there is a sharp decline from November 2019. There is a low the twist in the tail. See the these are the interest rates, and while going so, there is an operation. The yield rates are continuously increasing. So we need to decrease it whenever the Operation Twist is introduced here on the December 19th. So then the interest rates are also falling down. So this is a very good step in dealing with the reducing the interest rates